But as president, I must put the interests of America first.
And now, viewing our transition from on-TV's regular programming to adults only on TV's optional service, our specially selected feature will begin shortly.
Yes, indeed. That is one beautiful movie.
Hi, guys. This is Matai the Dead with another episode of Mondo Squallido. This is another special one, but for a completely different reason. And this is a film that I received maybe a month or so ago from the actual distribution company themselves to do a review of. And I've only just got around to doing this review. Not really had time or anything like that to watch the film because, of course, under the circumstances of where I live, it's very hard to watch adult material without getting pestered every 10 fucking minutes. Plus, I've had the shameless stuff to do, uni work and, things like that. So finally got around to watching this film today, and I'm finally getting around to doing the review. Look out in the next couple of days, as of today of the review, the date of the video review, for the full blog post where I go more in depth with my review. So expect that up within the next couple of days of the original upload of this video. And the film I'm watching, reviewing today, is the 2-disc collector's edition of The Private Afternoons of Pamela Mann, brought out by DistroPix and Video XPix. Again, they were kind enough to send me a copy of this for free for review. And you do get quite a lot in this edition. It's a very nice edition. And I'll go into a little bit more detail later on in the video of what you actually get in the set. And the film is from 1974, directed by Radley Metzger, otherwise known as, he used the name Henry Paris in his films, and it's actually under the name of Henry Paris that this film is directed. He's also directed films such as Camille 2000 and the opening of Misty Beethoven. I have to say, I don't think I've ever seen any other Radley Metzger, am I saying that right? Yeah, Radley Metzger titles. But I'm definitely, after watching this, definitely interested in some of his work. In the title role, Pamela Mann, we've got Barabra Bourbon, again, I hope I'm saying that right, who starred in Mondo Weirdo and also Girls for Rent. I don't think she's done many other films, both adult or otherwise. I'm not too sure. Looking on her IMDB, there weren't too many credits to her name. And then you've got, the big names in adult, classic adult films, like Eric Edwards, who's in Enema Killer and Teenage Twins, Alan Marlow, who's in Rollerbabies and Sweet Wet Lips. You've also got Jamie Gillis from The Enema Killer, Neon Knights, to name just a few of the films that Jamie Gillis has been in. You've also got Georgina Spelvin in there as well, who was in Police Academy, and again with Barbara Bourbon, Girls for Rent. Again, she's had a lot of credits to her name, so definitely check them out on the links down below. Well, the IMDb link anyway. And you've also got people like Marc Stevens, Mr. Ten and a Half himself in there as well, to name a few. It's a really big cast. The rest of the people involved, I'm not too familiar with, so it wouldn't be fair for me to, you know, talk about them. But there is a really big cast of, you know, well-known, you know, classic adult performers. So yeah, big class. And the film itself, before I start, I wouldn't suggest this film to newcomers to, you know, classic adult films. Mainly because it's not just your typical, you know, trashy, you know, adult film. It is very, very, you know, I don't know what the word is to use. It's very artful, to say the least. Very well done. Beautifully shot in places. Some great use of camera angles, especially in some of the, you know, the adult scenes as well. You know, really nice use of soft focus sometimes, and, you know, cleverly set up shots, and it's just really nice to look at. Acting wise, of course, you know, some of the acting from some of the people isn't too good, but, you know, Eric Edwards are really good in this. The person who plays Pamela Mann, Barabra Bourbon, she's, you know, good in it as well. Jamie Gillis, although he has a small role, you know, just playing Jamie Gillis, you know, typical Jamie Gillis, when he's in, like, a menacing role. But, yeah, all the actors and actresses play it well. There's, you know, the typical, you know, badly, you know, read out dialogue and sometimes badly written dialogue, but it just adds to the charm of it. But, yeah, at the heart of it, it's a very clever, it's very intelligent. Like I said, it's not, you know, just typical, you know, fuck scene after fuck scene after fuck scene. There are some really clever elements in there. It's a film that's very reflective on itself. There's also some really clever social and political commentary in there as well. Although towards the end of the film, it's almost seen as a, you know, a little bit of an in-joke as well. The fact that they talk about, you know, because Pamela Mann, she's basically like a socialite. She, you know, is pinned as this, like, woman who, you know, does a lot of community outreach and, you know, stuff like that. And every so often she'll be just, like, walking around, even in her own house, and then this, like, journalist woman will come in, ask her this really, you know, in-depth and difficult political question, and Pamela Mann will just answer it, and then she walks off. And then, like, every so often, this character comes in, which I thought was really good. It was funny. You know, he talks sometimes about the psychology of what's going through people's minds, especially Pamela Mann, you know. So, yeah, it's a very witty, it's intelligent, it's not your typical fur. You know, it's very arty, you know, technically excellent film in general. Not to say that I'm one of those people who thinks just because it's porn, it's not a great film. There have been some great, you know, adult films that are, you know, genuine films in my eyes. Just because it's, you know, porno doesn't mean, you know, the people involved shouldn't get the artistic respect that they deserve. But yeah, it's very clever. I enjoyed it. I got a laugh out of there as well. Some witty humour in there. Aside from some of the, you know, obvious porn cliches of, you know, bad dialogue and things like that. Story-wise, the story's very simple. Pamela Mann, as I said, she's like the socialite involved in all these things. And her husband, played by Eric Edwards, who has one of the most overly tanned faces that I've seen. I don't know whether it was done on purpose for his character or whether it was just a makeup thing. But yeah, he basically calls the services of Eric Edwards, who plays as like a private eye, but he's more of a, you know, peeping Tom private eye, which I thought was very interesting. And he's going around, you know, following Pamela, all the people that she's sleeping with and stuff like that, going back to this guy and, like, going really in depth with what he thinks is going through Pamela's mind and stuff. That goes throughout the whole film, but there's a really good twist at the end, which I'm not going to reveal or ruin, because if you are going to watch this, it won't like completely affect the film, but it does, you know, it's very clever what they do at the end of this film. And yeah, along the way, there's obviously, you know, the adult scenes in there, lots of blowjobs, throughout, not just from, you know, Pamela, but also the other female actresses in there. There's some lesbianism in there. There's like a staged rape sort of thing with Jamie Gillis and some other woman. I can't remember the other woman's name. But yeah, some good scenes, you know, some good, you know, sex scenes in there. You know, if you want a nice sleazy film, then this isn't the one for you. If you want some good, well shot, you know, adult scenes with a good story and good characters in there as well, then definitely check this one out. It's beautifully presented, a really gorgeous, you know, restored print. The audio is great as well, with a fantastic soundtrack, because I am partial to, you know, the odd porn soundtrack here and there. And yeah, just a great visual film. It's got a great story, it's got, you know, good characters in there. It's got very good, yeah, it's very clever in the use of narrative, because, yeah, the audience doesn't really know what's going on, and when you think you know what's going on, then something is revealed by one of the characters. And like I said, it's kind of complex in places, but nothing, yeah, that's going to be like, yeah, you're going to be confused or anything like that. But it's cleverly done, brilliantly shot, well directed, great cast, it looks gorgeous, it sounds great. Definitely, you know, it deserves its title as, you know, one of the greatest adult films of all time. It's definitely one of the most polished and well done films that I've seen. Plus, yeah, the obvious scenes are good as well, really well shot. Yeah, real mixed bag of stuff going on in there. So, yeah, like I said, if you're a newcomer to the adult film, you know, classic adult films, then maybe watch a few more titles before you pick this up, but it's definitely worth, you know, having in your adult collection. So yeah, like I said, packed full of special features. You get on disc one, you get the uncut hard version, which comes with a full-length audio commentary by Radley Metzger, which I just love the idea of porn directors doing audio commentaries. You've also got the original theatrical trailer, which runs for 6 minutes, Eric Edwards interview, which goes on for 40 minutes, basically just like him explaining how he got into the business and stuff like that. I've not watched it all the way through, that part, and I've not heard the audio commentary yet, but after watching the film, I'm really interested in, you know, hearing what has to be said about the film. And on disc two, you've got a soft version, which is 11 minutes shorter than the full uncut version. A Georgina Spelvin interview, which goes on for another 40 minutes. The locations of Pamela Mann, which I guess is just basically, you know, where some of the scenes were filmed. Also, Metzger's Manhattan, which again, I think it's similar lines, but, you know, just following Radley Metzger. The cutting room, the cutting floor, which runs for 9 minutes. Don't know what that is. You've also got the 2011 trailer, and also an ephemera gallery. So yeah, you do get a lot in terms of content on the disc, and also inside you get a couple of, you know, flyers advertising the music of Henry Paris, and also the complete library of films of Henry Paris. You get this really nice little, yeah, it's just a little extra of this like photo card with a picture of Barbara Bourbon on there as well, and a pretty sizable booklet, which basically just goes in depth into, you know, the director, the history of, you know, the film, pre-production, post-production, the people involved, the music, all sorts of good stuff like that. So yeah, you are getting a lot for your money, especially if you are, you know, a collector of adult films, then there is really no reason why you shouldn't pick this up. You know, not only is it a great, you know, a great film in general, one of the best adult features that I've seen, but you get a lot. It, you know, they're doing a great job for the fans, and I'd just like to thank everyone at, you know, DistroPix and VideoXPix for sending this out to me. Apologies, it took me so long to get around to review, but I hope you like the review, and like I said, look out for a blog review down below, in a couple of days when I get the time to. But yeah, overall, you need this in your collection if you want to start collecting adult films. Like I said, don't just go into this one without, you know, watching not too many. That's really badly constructed sentence there, Pete. Don't go into this without already watching a few, you know, classic adult films. Because, like I said, it's not your typical fur. It's, you know, it's got more, you know, depth than just, you know, a fuck picture. But yeah, some great, you know, hardcore scenes in there as well. And just an overall great film. Definitely gets the Mondo Squallido seal of approval. I'm never going to say that again, but yeah. If I can find a trailer on YouTube, which I doubt, I'll put it at the end of this video. But I'm going to throw loads of links down below for you to go check out. Not just, you know, more about this film, but, you know, DistroPix and VideoX Pix and, you know, all sorts of good stuff like that. So yeah, guys, that's another Mondo Squallido done. I really enjoyed watching this film. I hope you enjoyed the review. And until the next time, guys, I'll see you all later.
Do you think the welfare state is still viable, considering the inability up to the present of the system to reconcile the isolation of the poor with the assimilation into the system of a relatively well-to-do hierarchy of government administrators, corporate functionaries and executives, and the other white-collar elite who are the necessary benefactors of these poor?
No.
What's wrong, Greg?